What are the religions? They are the paths. The destination is one. That is divine realm. Begum Parashar, Nirankar ke desh jaye, formless stage. These are our religions. They are paths to reach one stage. That is to attain the one divine. Suppose I want to settle at Dhaka, and I come from Shimla, other come from Moscow and New York or London and other. I should say that for London man, you come to Shimla, I will take you to Dhaka. Why? There should be. Let them come, go on his own path. If we follow the path honestly, we reach the same destination. You might not have studied our scripture, Holy Granth, Guru Granth Sahib Ji. If you study that, you will find that there are divine hinds of only 6 gurus out of 10 gurus. 6 gurus. And there are the divine hinds of 15 saints. Saints belonging to Brahman, highly Brahman only. Then the rulers, even cobblers, butchers, even downtrodden communities, they were all one. They have, because they reached the same stage, divine realm. Whatever they have spoken, they have been recorded. Kabir was a Muslim and beaver. In our scripture, divine Guru Granth Sahib, from 10 gurus, divine hinds of only 6 gurus are there. Others are 15 saints belonging to different castes, and out of these are 4 Muslims. And Baba Fareed is, we have got great reverence and most respect for Baba Fareed. He has given many divine hymns and like that to shake up the band. So 4 Muslims, then 11 Pandit Bhats. So when we bow before our divine scripture, we don't bow before only 6 guru, divine hymns of 6 gurus. We bow before all those. It means this is a, in fact, Guru Granth Sahib, our divine scripture, Sikhism, is an interfaith religion. It is not a sectorial. We have got great, the same respect for Baba Fareed as we have got Guru Nanak hymns. So similarly, in the diversity, we get the unity. How we get the unity in the diversity? Because physically we are diverse. But when we search in ourselves, we find the same divine. Now we are here in shape and other colors coming from different countries. We are different shape, maybe different. But within ourselves, divine is one. If we search the divine, then diversity becomes the unity. There is no difference. Why there should be any difference when the destination is the same? So I am telling you frankly, this is the clarity which we should see. We should not see that my religion is better, other religion better. Why should we see? Follow honestly. So many saints in our divine scripture, Guru Granth Sahib, using washing the stone, they reached the same divine. But the honesty was there. Namdev offering milk to the stone deity, but he reached the divine realm because honesty was there. If honesty, devotion is there, you follow any path, you will reach the same destination. And this is my experience with the company of my divine masters and divine diamonds. So, secondly, in this universe, there are 2 powers, broadly. One is divine power, positive power. Other is a negative power, that is ego. There is no second power. Similarly, in our body, there are 2 powers. One is divine, that is called Atma. Soul, divine soul. And other is ego, that is called mind. Mind has got 5 vices, that is lust, anger, greed, attachment, and pride, arrogance. This is what is. These negative forces, they disturb all this. All the cues of floods and wars and the world, that is due to ego. If we remove the ego, we will become one. There will be all, I mean, Satyayuga, the old theme was that it was all peaceful. So only thing is, why we are different? Because we have got different levels of ego. That's why we are different. If we remove the ego, we are all one. This is the only one spiritual theory which we have imbibed from our teaching of the scripture, divine scripture. So other thing I must say that we have talked much about the how to improve the world. Our experience is that you catch hold of the children and give value-based education. That fellow from Nepal, he has illustrated some value-based education. What is value-based education? There are three types of education: literacy, value-based education, and spiritualized education. And literacy means learning of ABC of any subject. That creates more ego. You get more intellect. What is intellect? Intellect is ego. So literacy means at present, don't mind, 99% of the universities, colleges and the schools of the world are only teaching literacy, no value-based education. And what is the value-based education? When we combine the moral values, spiritual values with the literacy, that becomes value-based education. Value-based education means your vision becomes broader. You see one in all and all in one. Your spiritual brotherhood, divine peace in the world. You don't have any hatred. Third is the spiritualized education, that is Brahmgyan. For that you need not go to any school, college. That is within divine that you get the knowledge. Value-based education only the answer of the day. And we must test everywhere that we should impart the. This is our experience. We started school in 1986 with 5 children, one room. That old Gurukul system was started. That old sages and sages who used to start those type of schools. So we started that type of school. Very simple. No Western dress. Don't mind it. There was only Indian dress. And all vegetarian food. And you have to wake up early in the morning, take bath and go to the temple and do the prayer. Then the people used to ask us, no, your school will not run. Next year, 70 students came who were most notorious, and they become very good due to this discipline. If you keep the mind busy, the ideal brain is a devil's workshop. Keep always the mind busy. We used to keep them busy. If we go, they go to the ground, we used to ask them, go on reciting the divine name. There they remain busy. They become very good. They shed all the bad habits. Next year, 250 students came. Now the same school has got more than 1,400 students, residential school, English medium, CBSE. And those students have come from 16 countries. More than 100 students from America, and similarly more than from Canada and from Europe and India. And seeing that the Northern India, Punjab, Haryana, UP and Rajasthan, they told us that they opened the such type of school, because every student has motivated at least 30 to 35% of his family to shed drugs, shed alcohol, shed evil. Even divorces they have reduced. They have checked the divorces with all folded hands. There is a report of the CID that where our academy has been opened, in 35 kilometer radius, crime they have reduced, then drugs have been reduced, divorces have been reduced, and moral values are increased.